you're looking for some fun things to do with the kids over this winter break, we've got you covered with a few festive science experiments.
Joining us now is Jack Gallagher, a.k.a. Dr. Jackal, instructor from Mad Science of Chicago. Welcome back. Thanks for being here.
Thank you so much for having me back.
Yeah, my kids are already bored. We're barely past Christmas. Yeah. They haven't built the Legos all yet, but they were like, what do we do now?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we're going to be spending a lot of time indoors for the next couple of weeks. So, great time to start doing some science, right?
That is fantastic. And you guys go to people's homes, so if you can't recreate this yourself at home, you guys can help.
That's right. Yeah, we do birthday parties and private events and everything. Bring a mad scientist to your house and do some fun science. And yeah, it's a great time.
That's awesome. And you said you can keep it contained, so.
That's right. Yeah, we're gonna be very safe and contained here with our science today.
Okay. Yeah, it looks like you got a team of scientists, right? All over?
That's right. Yeah, we've got lots of scientists all over the Chicagoland area, and we work in schools. We do private events. We go to libraries, community centers, all kinds of fun stuff.
Great. That's okay. Cool. All right, what are we doing?
All right, so the first thing we're going to do is we are going to make some snow, because of course what we need right now is some more snow.
Right.
But the fun thing about this snow is you don't have to go outside in the cold to play with it. So what we have here is actually something called sodium polyacrylate. It's also known as Waterlock, so if you're looking to buy some, you can get it by searching Waterlock online.
Okay.
Another fun place you can get this is actually, it is what makes diapers absorbent.
So if you have, I know what that stuff is.
If you have some extra diapers at home, you can cut it open, pull out some of that fluffy stuff inside, and shake out the sodium polyacrylate.
Wait, this stuff is in there?
That's right. Now, the reason that we put it in diapers is because it is a super absorbent polymer, which means that it can hold up to several hundred times its mass in water.
Okay. I have unfortunately felt that stuff when it wasn't water.
Yes, I have as well. Yeah.
Not great.
But thank God it's in there. Yeah.
Right, exactly.
So, G, if you would like to just start pouring some water into our sodium polyacrylate here.
From here? From high up? Where?
Just close down is fine.
Oh, close down. Okay. How much?
Just keep going.
Keep going. Keep going.
We want to really saturate, and we're going to start to see.
Yeah, that stuff is crazy.
And as the water absorbs, and that should be enough there.
Perfect. This is from a good diaper company.
Yeah. So we can see that it's growing quite a bit, and it gives us some fun snow to play with. And you can do anything with this that you might do with sand or, you know, kinetic sand. It's totally safe to touch. It feels just like real snow.
It feels so weird.
And the great thing about this is it's safe, it's easy. You can get it online.
Can I make a snowball out of it?
Absolutely, yeah. You can compact it. You can, you know, fill a tray with it and play with, you know, cars and trucks. Anything you can do with real snow, you can do with our fake snow here.
Probably don't want to put dye on it, though, right? For coloring?
No, you don't want to dye it because it can create stains. Also, another thing is when you're done playing with it, you want to throw it right in the garbage and not put it down any drains.
Got it.
You know, it can cause some clogs and some problems.
Good to know.
But yeah,
weird flashbacks.
Yeah.
Weird flashbacks.
So we have all kinds of fun.
That is so cool.
That is so cool. Yes.
That is amazing.
Oh, very absorbent. Yeah.
That's how diapers have. Really good.
And, you know, this is just, this can be hours of fun right here.
Okay. Yeah. And I mean, I'm feeling it.
It can keep the water in for a long time, so you can just leave this and let it set. And
it's weird that it feels cold.
Yeah, well, the colder water you use, the colder you're going to get your snow.
Sorry.
It's very good.
I was just trying to replicate snow.
It's, it's hard. Yeah. It's easy to lose control. Now, the next thing I have for us here is actually we're going to make our own homemade lava lamps. Using things that everybody has in their kitchen right now. So what I have here is just some water with some food coloring in it.
Okay.
You can use whatever color you like. I like green. I think it's a very classic lava lamp
color,
right?
Holiday colors, too.
Yeah. So, Amy, if you want to add, what we have here is just some vegetable oil.
Okay.
If you want to just pour that on top, what we're going to see is, and right about there is good.
Okay.
As they mix, the vegetable oil is going to separate out of the water.
Okay.
This is a really fun experiment with density.
Yeah.
And it's a great time to tell your kids about Archimedes, a very famous scientist who, when he stepped into a bathtub, noticed that the water level rose and had an epiphany about buoyancy and density, and famously ran through his town shouting, "Eureka," which means, "I got it." And that has become synonymous with scientific discovery now.
Eureka, yes.
Eureka! Yes.
So now we can see we've got a good separation of our oil.
I'm going
to add in just a little sprinkle of glitter here for some fun sparkles.
Ooh, everybody loves the sparkles.
Beautiful. Yeah.
Now, just going to pour some table salt over it.
Just some salt, regular salt, huh?
Yeah. And what we're going to see is as the salt settles down.
They're like little snakes.
It's going to pull some of that oil down into the bottom. And as the salt begins to dissolve, the oil is going to resettle back to the top.
That's
Is that how the lava lamp works?
Well, lava lamps, traditional lava lamps work through heat creating different levels of also density. But if you want to get even more of that lava lamp effect, you can shine light through it. If you have a puck light, you can set it on there. You know, you can use some different colored lights
so cool.
Give it even more of that lava lamp effect.
Just need your 70s outfit.
Yes, of course. Yeah.
Dim the lights.
Crack out the black lights.
Yeah,
some posters.
Yeah, there we go.
Get some big hair going and you're ready to go.
Cool.
That is amazing.
Ooh, yes. Look at the glitter.
That is so awesome. And I love this.
And you know, as it starts to settle out and the salt really dissolves, you can just add more salt in and you can keep the lava lamp going for as long as you want.
That is so cool. And yeah, it's so easy to do this stuff at home.
You can even put it in a container with a lid and shake it up and restart the whole thing over again. Watch the separation happen again.
Wow.
Fabulous.
This is awesome.
I need a lid for later, okay?
Dr. Jekyll, thanks for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
So fun.